It's another beautiful day in the world of Anime Fighting Simulator. We went on and we as well mastered every single new ability in the fighting pass.
If you want to see more videos, be sure to hit subscribe and ding dong the notification bell for more videos every single day. If you've done that, go comment down below hashtag Pink Army. Let's get this going and enjoy the video.
But of course, there's a bunch more powers out there that need mastering. So what I'm doing, guys, I'm grouping them all, of course, together in their respective tier. For example, the stance is going to be one video for the pyrokinesis, one video for every bloodline, etc, etc. So there's going to be a bunch of powers to master. So we're going to get started with, of course, the pyrokinesis today, because this is the power I've literally experimented the least with. After I've mastered every single power in the whole game, I'm gonna make a top list on every power there is, and I can let you know how every single one of them is compared to the other one, because I've literally used every power in the game and mastered it. So we're starting with the pyrokinesis. So what we're gonna do, guys, we're gonna go first check out electricity, then radiation, then devil's flame, and then severed universe. We're gonna check them all out, and we're gonna see, of course, how good they are. Are they gonna be good or not? It's gonna be the question. So we're starting with electricity. I'm, by the way, not really gonna take them into the overworld for the PvP aspect. I'm just gonna test them on dummies, but I'm gonna take them though in the boss, because we can sort of see how it's gonna go in PvP from the dummies, and the bossing, of course, is very important as well, because it's gonna be used for bossing. So we're gonna start with electricity. It has a lightning blast, it has a wave of energy, and as well as a giant electric explosion stunning everyone. Okay, so let's first see how this is gonna go. We're gonna go into the air, we're gonna press Z over here. It's gonna allow us to target. So this is, of course, going to be very good for PvP. You're going to be able to beam someone across that beautiful lane. So let's see. Oh, it doesn't go that far, but I think it doesn't have auto aim. Let's actually see if it has auto aim. I'm not going to aim at the target. I'm going to jump, and it is auto aim. Ooh, really good. That already gets a point for me. Okay, so that's the set ability. Let's check out the X ability right now. The X, again, seems to be an auto aim. Let's check it again. So, boom, we're going to jump up and press X. Ooh, can we not use it? Oh, we can use the midair, but it doesn't do anything. So this is only a standalone, or maybe it's an aim. Let's do a check it one more time. We're resting right now. It's done. Let's compress the X ability. No, it is literally only usable on the ground. Okay, let me go maybe a little bit closer. It could have a shorter range. Let's check it one more time. Oh, okay, so that's shorter range. So this one is pretty, like, of course it's gonna do more damage, but if it's closer range, it's kind of bad, if I may be honest, because of course with the Z ability you can use your Q and E at the same time. So this is a really good ability already. Okay, so we got that, and then of course the last one is the C ability. This is gonna change the whole pyrokinesis. So let's just see. Ooh, okay, a giant AoE. Actually, I will say that the pyrokinetic powers are extremely good from the get-go. Like, literally the lowest one already is really good. Can I use it mid-air? Yes, I can, but it's not. Ooh, it seems that it hits, but I don't see any of the damage hit splits. Let's check it one more time. Let me see. Come on, please. Can I use it again? Can I use it again? Can I use it again? There we go, and boom. Okay, there we go. It did hit. Okay, so we can use all that midair, so that's gonna be really good for bossing. So let's quickly take it into a boss and see how it does. Taking out our trustworthy Marco right now for every power as well. So let's just see how this is gonna go. So we're gonna go into the air, we're gonna press the C ability, we're gonna go use both of the powers. I didn't hit him with that. Okay, so that's a bit of a bad one. So the C ability is not reliable because it takes so long to charge. Let's check out the X ability as well. So we're gonna use the X ability. This one actually did hit. You can see it right there from the boss's HP. Okay, so the X is a little bit more reliable, but I think probably the winner is going to be the Z ability right here, because it's going to be in the air. Boom, it does a lot of damage. Yeah, I think probably the Z ability is the best one for this power, because it goes really far, auto targets, everything is really good. So, okay, we actually unlocked Tailbone as well. That's actually pretty crazy. From a boss I surrendered, I unlocked the power. I didn't even know that was possible. All right, that's power 1 out of 4. What I would rate this one is, I would give this one a solid 7 for PvP because of the auto target mode. It's always really nice. It's a little bit wonky. Sometimes it does it, sometimes it doesn't. That's why it's like a 7. Okay, we'll give it a 7.5. Not 7.5 for PvP. I'll give it a 7 for bossing. It seems to be a little bit unreliable. It doesn't do that much damage. It does its job, but its main damage, of course, is getting from pressing your Q and your E and your R, etc. to use your auto spell. So it's decent. It's not the best, but in my opinion, for a green perk, it gets a job well done. Of course, as well, Griff, be sure sure to put the numbers on the screen that I give the perk. Give me the radiation. There we go. We got ourselves radiation as the next one. Let's go check this one out real quick. So we got a beam that targets a player. We got ourselves 6 swift beams exploding in front of you in impact. And we got ourselves aim a volatile beam that devastates the area that you choose. Okay. So quickly, guys, gonna get into it. We're gonna go ahead and not use the mouse. So it's gonna go where the mouse is. Okay. So we know that. We know where that we need to aim the mouse 100% for the Z ability. So let's go use it again. Boom. It didn't hit though. It didn't hit. It doesn't go that low. It doesn't go that low. Let me try it again. It didn't hit. So this is a very close range attack. It means that the Z ability is useless for PvP and for PvE because you have to be way close to the boss to use the powers. So let's see. Can the X change that? Let's go midair. Can we use it? We cannot. It goes just in front of you. So again, this is a power we cannot use. I'm a little bit disappointed about that one because, like, how short range is this? It looks better, but like in midair, it just doesn't hit. I don't know why it doesn't hit. Like, I'm not that far away from the things, and it just does no damage. It just does no damage. That's very interesting. This probably will work on the boss, but it doesn't work in PvP. So the last one is going to be a C ability. Let's see. Can I use it midair? I can, and it does do damage this time. Okay. It does damage. Let me just get real close with this one. I really want to see. Does it really do no damage? I'm actually so surprised that it does seem no damage. Okay. So, this C ability, though. This C ability. We didn't give it enough credit, but look at that. That does so much damage, if you see that. That's insane. So, it's gonna be really good for PvP as well, this C, because it's such a big area. You can just use it, and it's just gonna hit the ground. You can see right there. I'm just gonna be like, yeah, right there. And if you're on the ground, I think it probably will hit midair as well. That's actually insane. Okay. So, I'm gonna do one last jump and use the Z ability. Come on. Okay. So, it seems to hit if I'm a little bit lower. So, let's check it out on the boss. How does it work on this one? So the only powers we need to test are the Z and the C, because the X ability is going to be really bad because it's just like a shotgun in front of you. So can I hit the boss midair from here? And the answer is yes, but 5 damage. What is that? Okay, it just does 5 damage. What is that? Okay, and that does that at like 45. It seems that it does multiple hits, so that's actually not bad at all. So I'm gonna summon my champion right now. We're gonna go from 5. Okay, so we're gonna go in the air. We're gonna press the C ability. Boom, boom, boom. And it's gonna do some massive damage. Okay. It doesn't do the greatest damage because a lot, again, is from my own abilities. And the C as well, a big bad thing about this is that it has such a long cooldown. But it is like a respectable 69 damage. So I will take it, to be honest. And so the radiation... I don't know. I think this one's pretty bad. Like, it's okay. I would give it a 6 in PvP. It has no auto aim. It has a long cooldown if you want to use the good ability, which is a C ability. So I would give it a 6 in PvP. PvE, I would probably give it the same one. Again, it doesn't do the most damage. If it's a very fast boss, he's going to just evade the C ability because it does multiple hits. It doesn't do one gigantic hit on the beam. So yeah, I think a 6 all around for both of them is pretty acceptable. And next up, we have Devil's Flame, one I'm really excited about because this one could really be good. So we got ourselves a Blazing Kick, we got ourselves the Inferno and the Corna. I'm not really gonna read them, I'm just gonna use them. That's what I'm gonna do. Okay, so midair, the Z ability is okay, that's very wonky. Okay, I think it's maybe I'm too far away for the ability. Let's check that out one more time. So I am rested, so I can use it right now. I can use it. And, okay. Yeah, it seems to be pretty wonky. But let's go check it out one more time. Can I use it from here or am I too far away? No, I'm too far away. So this is not a PvP ability. It's way too short range. Because if you have to get closer than this to one-shot someone, they probably can do the same thing to you. You want to have like an element of surprise to defeat someone. So Z ability is probably no-go. Let's check out the X ability. Let's check it out midair. Does it do damage? Yes or no? It is a front kick that does not target. Okay. So this one could be interesting though, because it's a little bit like the sun style. If you could go through some... this could go through the boss and you could take no damage. Ooh, this could be a boss ability. Again, no PvP ability. So right now, still this quirk has like 0 PvP stuff. So let's check out the C ability. What does that one do? I'm just going to use it right there. Boom, it's going to be a gigantic AoE, which is very short range again. Okay. Is it going to hit midair? Yes or no? Let's go check it right here. Let's use it again. Can I use it even midair? I don't think I can. Oh, I can use it midair. It doesn't hit downward. Okay, so this is... Okay, it has a short-range target. It has a short-range target. I think that's the only thing I can give this quirk. It has a short-range target, which is okay. It's a back attack as well. This is probably like... This is going to be a bad number for PvP. Let's see if it's going to redeem itself on the bossing though. All right, so the only thing I can think of is that the Z ability is going to be pretty okay because you TP behind. No, I still get hit. It's a way too long of an animation, so the Z ability is absolutely garbage. Okay, so the only thing I can think of is that the X ability is pretty good, but it did like five. That wait, did how much did it do? Okay, 946. 946. Let's check it out one more time. I'm not getting it. So 946. Is that it only does 16 damage, and that is with Marco buffing it for 50. So it does like 10 base around that. That's actually really, really bad. Okay, okay. The only thing I have to check out is the C ability. Like this one's again, it does 8 damage. Okay, this is this quirk. I thought it was gonna be good. It's so bad. By the way, I know I said quirk. I don't know. Like, I'm just my head's full. My Hero Academia that every power is a quirk. It's not a quirk. It's a pyrokinesis. But like, okay, this thing. I'm just gonna say it. I think Devil's Flame is an absolute zero. Like at PvP, it's gonna be trash. I know it has an auto aim, but it's way too short range. The X ability is garbage. The C ability is garbage for PvP. For PvE, it's the same deal. It's just way too bad. Like, you're way better off just getting yourself the Astro Grimoire and just spamming some airs from the air. Like, the X ability could have a little bit of potential because you don't get hit, but I don't think you can kill the boss in time. I don't think so. So, of course, it maybe could if it's like a tier one, but, you know, now I'm still going to give it a zero. I'm sorry. We're going to go to the last one, the Severed Universe. There we go, guys. We get ourselves Severed Universe unlocked. Beautiful. Okay. This technically should be the best one. I think at the moment, the best one is still the green. The green one. The most common of all of them. So, okay. Let's go test it out. So, we got ourselves the Severed Slash, the Timed Slashes, and the Severed Universe. So, let's see how they are. Okay, so first of the Z ability, let's use it midair. Can we hit something? Is it actually active? It's not active yet. Okay, so the Z ability, we have to have a sword equipped. Okay, let's check it again. And boom! Okay, so this does no damage midair. It is going to be, of course, pretty bad then for PvP as an ability. But let's go check it out one more time on the ground. It does just a slice. Okay, okay. So then we have ourselves the X ability. This is going to be midair. We're going to be resting. And we can use it right now. Ooh, auto target. And of course, probably if it's one target, it's just gonna hit it once, or it's gonna hit it three times. So we're gonna, of course, have to check out how that is gonna go. Then we got ourselves, of course, the C ability. Let's go check that one. And this one, I think it's... Okay. So that's the stopping time, but it's a slash through. Okay, so this quirk again gets... Oh my god. This pyrokinetic power gets a zero for PvP. That's going to be absolutely garbage. It is. So it has a little bit of auto targeting. Maybe I give it a little bit. No, yeah, you have to be on the ground. So you have to be on the same level to even use the X ability, which is the auto target one. I think it's going to be pretty bad. But it has a little bit of potential because it can hit multiple people. So, okay, I'll give it a four for PvP. A four. Just because it has multiple targeting. But again, it's not in the air. It has no air like giant AoE attack. Or whatever, so it gets a four for PvP, but can it bring it back for the PvE bossing aspect? Because this one has some interesting capabilities, probably. So let's go check out. We'll just do every single one of them. So we have the Severed Slash, which of course can be used, but it does only 8 damage with Marco. Wow, that's again bad. I don't know why these pyrokinetic powers have such low bossing slaying power. I have no clue. Okay, so we get that one. Then we have ourselves the X ability. We're gonna go ahead. It does nothing. It does nothing. It doesn't TP. It doesn't TP on mobs? What? Okay, and then we have ourselves the C ability, and this one just locks me in and gets me smacked around by the boss again and does no damage. Okay, it did like 10 damage. I'm sorry, Kuruma, you win again. Like, this is just sad. This is a sad day for the pyrokinetic powers. They're absolutely garbage. Wow. Okay, that gets a zero for bossing for me. I could never in my life probably defeat a boss with these powers. Like with this power, with the yellow one, with the severed universe. So that would get a zero for bossing. So the final verdict, like a four for PvP and a zero for bossing. This is not looking too great for the pyrokinetic powers. So we went ahead and we mastered every single power there is about the pyrokinesis special, I would say. And my verdict is don't get this. Like, electricity is good. I would say electricity is good. It's a good power. I would recommend electricity if we have to recommend any of them. It's the easy one to get. So this is always a very good point. Like, if you don't have a lot of Chikara, you can literally almost guarantee the electricity pyrokinesis power in like two or three spins. So that's also really good. You can use it for bossing. You can use it for PvP. So that's really nice. But as a whole, I will probably have to give this power a 2 out of 10. Like, okay, 2.5 out of 10. Because only one of the four ones is actually usable. So a 2.5 out of 10 is going to be my final verdict for the pyrokinetic power. So get yourself electricity or get yourself nothing at all. Radiation, devil, flame, severed universe, all is not worth it unless you want to be completionist like I do and have yourself every highest tier power unlocked on the account. Go for the severed universe, but that's probably the only like thing that it could deserve as an unlock, because it's just an absolutely bad power. I think the pyrokinesis should be definitely reworked or given a lot more boss power, because right now it's just absolutely garbage. So there we have it, guys. We mastered another power inside of the game. Of course, we have ourselves a lot to go. I think next episode we want to go try out the stands, because this is again one I'm not familiar with at all, to be honest. And they have some very rare chances, so it would be pretty cool to see how hard it will be for me to get them all in one video. So if you've enjoyed, of course, this master video, hit that like button down below, guys. Subscribe if you are new, and of course, hit that notification bell down below, guys. Would be highly appreciated. Let me know what do you guys think about the pyrokinetic powers for today's video. Do you agree with my grading, or do you think I'm totally wrong on some of them? Let me know, of course, in the comment section down below, and maybe suggest which power you want to see mastered next. So I'll say, guys, take care, love you, bye, thanks so much for watching, and of course as well, take care.